reduces self-consciousness to middle point. Separated unit identifies himself with his rear type, S-D-3-572-I-183-623-F, Atmic Consciousness, 6. The consciousness of the unit of the subtenary solar system, S-D-2-673-2-741. These two embody super consciousness. The seventh type embraces them all and is God consciousness. S-D-D-740-NOTE. Study also S-D-I-300-301-183-221-623. Planet similarly charged, for it is a known law that light particles consciousness of seeing its opposite and coming under the law of attraction, which leads to atomic, human, planetary, spiritual, solar, and cosmic marriage. This idea is comparatively simple in relation to a human being and can be seen in daily demonstration in his contacts with other men. These contacts are governed, for instance, very largely by his likes and dislikes. All these attractions and repulsions are under law, and their cause exists in form itself. The emotion of like or dislike is nothing else but the realization by the conscious entity of the human and given magnetic radius of an atomic form which he is led, by the very law of his own being, to either attract or repulse. Only when the form is transcended, and spirit seeks out spirit, will the phenomena of repulsion cease. This will be the inevitable finale of the cessation of solar evolution, and it will bring about Relia. The duration of the interplay, the period of the search of spirit for spirit, and INTROPECTIONS 281. The vibratory process investigated by the visualization of the form, this we call time, whether in connection with a man, a planetary logos, or the deity. Space, again, is included in the idea of consciousness and its utilization of matter. Space, for the logos, is literally the form wherein his conscious activities and purposes are worked out with solar ring past knots. The space wherein a planetary logos works out his plans is similarly as much of solar space as his consciousness is developed enough to use. As in the case of the newly evolved, or maybe inclusive of a portion of planetary space of great extent, and even in the case of the very highly evolved may begin to touch the periphery of the sphere of influence of the planetary logos in whose body he is a cell. Space for the atom, for instance, the atom in the physical body of man, will be the radius of the form in which is found the greater center of consciousness of which it is a part, and it will be both attracted and repulsed, attracted and built into the form of the greater life, yet repulsed and thereby prevented from moving from a certain point within that form. We have here dealt a little with time and space and their relation to a specific